the hell happened in there?
Don't worry, babe. I got it. I dropped the glass by mistake. That's all.
So fucking stupid.
I'm cleaning it up, Tim, as fast as I can.
Clean this shit up now with your dumb ass, all right? And hurry up, because we gotta go. But you know what? We're already late for church. I don't think I even want
to
go anymore.
Tim, why are you yelling? You said that when we got married, you would start going to church more often when you didn't have to work.
Well, I lied. Look, I didn't say what I needed to get you, and it worked, didn't it? I got you. You're my wife. But you know, I don't even know how you do any work at the office. Just something fucking screw up. All messed up.
Well, I'm sorry that I'm such a disappointment to you. You know what? I'll be ready in a little bit. I just need to grab some things from the foyer so I can take back to the church.
Come on, Lynn. I don't got time for this shit. Let's go.
Calm down before the neighbors hear you.
Neighbors? I don't give a fuck about them neighbors. Look, you think you better than me? Huh? You think you perfect? Because you're not. Come on.
Lynn, sweetheart, God loves you more than you could ever imagine. Don't ever let anyone tear you down with their words. Always remember, you were created by God, my dear. You were fearfully and wonderfully made.
Sometimes I feel like giving up. It seems like my best just ain't good enough. Lord, if you hear me, I'm calling you. Do you see? Do you care all about what I'm going through? And then he said, one more day, one more step. See, I'm preparing you for myself. And when you can't hear my voice, please trust my plan. And the Lord I see, and yes, I understand. But sometimes I feel like I'm all alone. I'm just like a stranger so far from home. I feel like I've done all that I can do. Please, Lord, give me strength. I'm just trying to make it through. That's when he told me, oh,
one more day,
one more step, yeah,
one more step,
oh, my child, I'm preparing you for
myself.
And when you can't hear my voice,
he has mental health issues, Jen. He's bipolar, and one time he said his doctor diagnosed him with schizophrenia. I'm scared, girl. I don't know what to do. I don't want to lose my husband.
He's still married?
He said this after we were married.
Okay, sis, listen. Even though your husband has these mental health issues, you still have to take responsibility for your own actions. You either have to seek counseling together or alone. Or separate for a little while and hope and pray things get better. Or just leave all together if you think your life is at stake. Let's walk. I think it's the exercise.
Yeah, girl. Me too. You know, he tried counseling. He won't go back. He said that they can't tell nothing. They already don't know. They don't know what they're talking about. Pray for me, Jen. Pray for us. People with mental health issues be low too.
Yes, they do, but love doesn't hurt you, right? Love Bible says about love? Love is patient. Love is kind. It doesn't envy or boast. It's not proud. It doesn't dishonor others. Isn't self-seeking or easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love doesn't delight in evil, but rejoices at the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
Thank you, sis.
You can pray for them from afar, but you can have them direct. God's got great plans for your life, but we're letting you write it that way. Okay. That's what Sister Christ is for. Listen, I have to learn. My mom made dinner for the family, and I don't want to be late.
Okay.
You should come join us.
I can't. You know how it is if I'm not recording tomorrow. Riggles completely off.
I'm praying. You're both in control.
See ya.
Action!
Beautiful woman I've ever laid eyes on.
Oh, really?
Yes, absolutely. Kid you not.
Okay. Do you agree most women with that line?
No, just you. May I ask your name?
Lynn.
Lucas. Lucas Graham. Mrs. Just say. Miss Lynn. Pleasure to meet you. What? I'm glad to see you laughing. That's not the look you had earlier when I passed by. May I ask you a question?
Sure. I don't see why not.
Did you go to church this morning?
Yes, I did. Did you?
Did I what?
Go to church this morning.
Yes. And I've attended the same church for over 40 years. It's a wonderful church. More importantly, what a wonderful God we serve.
Yes, very true. Amen to that. What a wonderful God indeed. He's always there for us, no matter what our situations look like. You know, he always keeps us from falling. He is always on time.
Okay, okay. Preach, preach. I hope you don't mind me asking. But earlier when I passed by, you seemed a little worried. Stress. Something bothered you? If so, want to talk about it? Maybe I can help.
How can you help me? You don't even know me.
Well, first of all, I'm a licensed therapist. A simple guy. I live up the road, church around the corner, and my office is in Cherry Hill. Laid back, simple life.
So are you married?
Nope, never been. Still waiting for the Lord to bless me with a woman to call my own. If it's his will.
So,
pretty patient.
Are you involved with anyone?
No, not at the moment. And I'm not sexually active with the women that I do date. But if I have to slip up about being in a relationship, I use protection.
Okay, TMI.
I'm sorry, I got to stop myself. Listen, I didn't mean to scare you. Just that when I'm interested, very interested in a woman, I want her to feel comfortable around. I want her to know everything about me. I want to help, but only if you're open to it. If not, I'm happy to be your friends, or just a confidant. So will you let me?